Well, we have always thought of Lleyton Hewitt as one of the greatest of all time, and now the International Tennis Hall of Fame has just confirmed that. It's very aggressive, Renito. The Aussie champ will be inducted this Saturday, becoming the 32nd Aussie to receive the honour.
The one and only Lleyton Hewitt joins us now live from the US. Lleyton, good morning to you, brother. We're so proud of you. You're officially one of the game's greatest players. How does that feel for you?
No, it's pretty exciting, but I think you do that logo pretty well there, mate. You get pretty into it. It's good to see.
I love it, mate.
It's an unbelievable honour. As I keep saying, it's something I have to pinch myself, to be honest. As a kid growing up in Adelaide, I really thought the Hall of Fame of tennis was set out for all my idols and superstars of the sport. And, I never once thought that I could possibly be in that. And it's not something that when you're playing that you ever think about either. So, very fortunate to celebrate it with my family over here in the States. And it's going to be a fantastic weekend.
Look, I mean, I know you actually awarded this honour last year, but with COVID travel restrictions, it got in the way. What does it mean to you?
It means an awful lot, and especially coming from Australia. I feel like I've loved the history of tennis in Australia and all the past greats, and I've looked up to so many of those guys for so many years and really been led by John Newcomb and Tony Roach, and then having a guy like Pat Rafter, kind of like an older brother to me, really, on the tour when I first came on the stage as a 16-year-old, and winning big Davis Cup matches with him, and then obviously Mark Philippoussis as well when we went on to win the title. And this is, a special thing for our country and for Australian tennis. So there's so many people that make the moments remarkable. And I guess for me, that's the special thing, to be able to celebrate it with some of those people.
It's the 20th anniversary. I can't believe it. It feels like yesterday of your Wimbledon win. To win Wimbledon from Adelaide, it is something extraordinary, something incredibly special to do. You must have the fondest of memories of that.
Feels like a bloody long time ago, that's for sure, being over there at Wimbledon this year. And everyone kept telling me about 20, and I guess I'm lucky that I won it when I was 21 years old. So I've been able to celebrate it for a number of years already. But it's an unbelievable feeling to go back there to the All England Club as a former winner. There's something so special about that championships and playing on grass and holding up that gold trophy. So, I do have to pinch myself every time I go back there and I see on the honour board my name. And, it's nice to go back to those kind of places where I had a lot of success throughout my career, and now my kids can sort of see it all as well.
You look so
young.
Like a grommet.
Thanks, mate.
Just talking Wimbledon too, Nick Kyrgios's performance in the final, what did you think of it?
I thought he handled the situation and the pressure and expectation really well. We're always going to see Nick come out there and be himself on the big stage. I've been there alongside him in enough big Davis Cup matches, and he'd done it throughout the whole tournament as well. And so for him, he was always going to go out there and try and make it awkward for Novak, and he was able to do that early on. If he could have potentially stayed with Novak early in the second set and tried to build some real scoreboard pressure on him, then it could have been interesting because, when someone's playing against Nick, especially on grass, in tie breaks, in sets, it's not easy because he can take the game away from you because he has so much firepower. But Novak, being the true champion that he is, he was able to find a way to get back into the match. Once he started getting it on his terms, then it was going to be really hard for Nick to turn it around.
Yeah, you're 100% right. In that second set, if he'd been able to square that away, you might have seen Novak starting to go off a little bit and Nick getting inside under his skin a little bit. Anyway, the future bodes pretty well for Nick, though, depending on what he decides to do.
Yeah, absolutely. I think the biggest thing for him is just the belief that he can go there and last the 2 weeks of a Grand Slam event in singles. Up until now, he'd really only been able to do it on the doubles court at the Australian Open earlier this year, which I think gave him a lot of confidence and belief as well, and probably gave him that drive that he wants to have more success out there at the big tournaments. And I know he's been training a lot harder. He doesn't always talk about it, but he does a lot of his things behind closed doors as well that a lot of people don't see. And he goes about it in his own way, but he had a fantastic whole grass court season.
Lleyton, great to talk to you. Hearty congratulations from everyone, not just here at the Today Show, Ali and I, but right around the country. No one worked harder and no one deserves this more. It's great to see you, brother.
Give us a come on.
No, I appreciate it. Thanks. Come on.
Yeah, come on.
He does it.
We look so unco when we do it.
I'm not doing it again. I'm done.
Fair enough. You're a good sport to do it
then. Congrats, brother.
Congrats, Lleyton. Yeah.